I really believe this is part of the problem in the church today, the anointing of the Holy Spirit over His servants. As we have models in the church, in the congregation, within the pulpits of America, men that are godly men, men that are anointed of God, because of the anointing that the Holy Spirit has put over their lives, like Elijah and Elijah.
Welcome to Somebody Loves You Radio, the Bible teaching ministry of Roll Race in Diamond Bar, California. Thanks for joining us today in 2 Kings, a book rich with history that can energize our modern day faith as we think about God's mighty hand at work in ancient Israel. Today, Roll will begin by encouraging us to take more time to listen for God as the prophet Elijah did, allowing him to direct our lives and fill us with his Holy Spirit. At the end of today's study, we'll tell you about a book with more insight into the power of a Spirit-led life. But first, here's Roel Reese in 2 Kings chapter 1.
Tonight we're starting 2 Kings, and 1 and 2 Kings in the Jewish Bible is just one book. In our book, it's actually two books. But turn to 2 Kings chapter 1, and we're going to begin with verses 1 tonight, and just kind of look at what happened here. In the last meeting we had, Ahab, the king of Israel, now has died, and his wicked wife Jezebel. And they were really a real thorn to the side of Israel, because not only did they introduce Baal worship, but also the worship of Ashtoreth. And it seems that at this particular time when the kings were written, there was a spiritual apostasy going on among the people, and we'll see that in a moment. And I was kind of blown away the other day on Saturday. I thought, you know what? I'm going to go down to Brea, go down over here to Chino Hills, go down to Laverne, and just kind of go to different places and kind of look around and see what people do on Saturdays. And so I went down, and I was just really amazed at all the activities that are going on Saturday morning and probably also Sunday mornings. One of the things that is killing the church and killing the world is pleasure and materialism. Because when there's a time of pleasure and a time of materialism, hey, why seek God when I have my bank account or I have my Visa? When there are so many parks we can visit, Knott's Berry Farm or Disneyland. Or we can go down to the beach, or we can go up to the mountains or the desert. Or we can do something on the weekend, especially on Sundays. And then at the same time, when we say, where is the God of Elijah? My question is, where has the power gone? The power for God to really move among us, as he did in times past. Look at chapter 1, beginning with verse 1 now. He says that Moab rebelled against Israel after the death of Ahab. Now, Moab, if you've been to Israel with us, that as we go over the hill in Jerusalem, going down through Bethany, down into Jericho, you're coming down through Jericho, and when you get to Jericho, you can see the actual Dead Sea. And then across, you see these huge mountains in the wilderness area. These are the mountains of Moab. And on the other side is the city of Jordan. These people were constantly a thorn to the side of Israel. And now that they saw that Ahab and Jezebel had died, and that Ahaziah, their son, now was ruling, that maybe now they could take on Israel. Because they knew that Ahaziah was a poor son. But listen, how many times Does God deal not only with righteous people, but how many times does he deal with the wicked? He deals with them because God wants to give his grace, his love, and his mercy to them if they'll repent. Ahaziah was not a dummy. Ahaziah was not ignorant of the fact that there was a God by the name of Jehovah God. Even though his mom and dad worshiped Baal and Ashtaroth, hey, you go back in the lineage of Israel, the other kings, and then the kings of Judah, that not only were wicked, but those that were righteous and worshiped God. And it's amazing because Ahaziah, the son of Ahab and Jezebel, somehow was walking in his patio and he fell through the patio and got hurt. God used that to judge him, to get his attention. Watch this. And now Ahaziah fell through the lattice in his upper room in Samaria and was injured. And so he sent messengers and said to them, go inquire of Beelzebub, the god of the Ekron, whether I shall recover from this injury. Can you imagine? Here is a man seeking after his gods that don't answer. That don't answer. He is worshiping the god Beelzebub. You've heard of that. The god of the flies. They worship flies. Flies are very interesting creatures. They can see 360 degrees around. And then they have these wings that they're just magnificent when you look under the microscope. And then the most amazing thing about a fly is that you watch them, and how do they know when they're coming to the ceiling, now I got to flip over so I can hang. That quick. The brain of the fly. Think about that. What an awesome God we have. Where that fly just, and he's on. Doesn't say, well, I got 3 feet to go, then I'll flip over. He does a thing like that. With radar. And these people in Israel were worshiping flies, which are irritants to me. And it's amazing because these people, here is God allowing the king to fall through his lattice, get hurt, so that he can call on God. But who does he call on? The god of the flies. Beelzebub. Heal me. Watch this. But the angel of the Lord said to Elijah the Tishbite. Now, notice how God is in control of the wicked and the righteous. When God heard what Ahaziah was doing, he went and spoke to who? To the true prophet of God, Elijah. Look what he says to him. Get up and go and meet the messengers of the king of Samaria and say to them, he said, because there is no God in Israel that you are going to inquire of Beelzebub, the god of Ekron. Hey, how in the world does God know what I'm thinking or saying? Because he's omnipresent. Listen, the reason he goes to Elijah is because God is a God of love and a God of grace and a God of mercy. The reason he's sending Elijah to rebuke these fellows is to let them know, hey, there is a real God. The God that you worship is a phony God. You see? He's given Ahaziah an opportunity to repent, to come to the grace and the mercy. When I think of all the opportunities that God uses on the wicked and an accident on the freeway, you know, the chaplain comes up and talks to the person dying and they'll say, no, I don't want Christ in my life. And then they die. Think about that. How God knows what's going on. 24/7 with the righteous and the wicked. And here God is extending the arm of fellowship and grace and mercy and love to Ahaziah the king to see how he would respond to the prophet of God.
This is Somebody Loves You Radio with Raul Reese. Visit us at SomebodyLovesYou.com to explore our full array of faith-building resources. And for timely Bible-based guidance in your daily life, join Raul for Straight Talk on his YouTube channel every Tuesday at 10 a.m. West Coast time. Let's continue now with more of today's study.
The angel of the Lord here, of course, is a theophany in the Old Testament of who? Jesus Christ. The angel of Jehovah came personally to Elijah. And he says, go and meet the messenger of the king of Samaria and say unto them, he said, because there is no God in Israel that you are going to inquire of Baal-zebub, the god of Ekron. Now therefore, thus saith the Lord. Here's now, God says, you shall not come down from the bed to which you have gone up, but you shall surely die. Whoa, what a message. Hey, listen, Elijah, you tell his messengers to forget about it. Ahaziah is going to die. He doesn't want to repent. He doesn't want the God of Jehovah, God Jehovah. Notice the one that is creator of the heavens and the earth. And then what happens? So Elisha departed with that message. And when the messengers returned to him, he said to them, why have you come back? And so they said to him, a man came up to meet us. This is the king said, hey, how come you came back so fast? Didn't you go? No, he says, well, a man came up to meet us and said to us, go and return to the king who sent you and say to him, thus saith the Lord Jehovah, he said, because there is no God in Israel that you are sending to inquire of Baal-zebub, the god of Ekron. Notice that he's given him another opportunity. How many opportunities do people need before they come to judgment and death? God is sending the speaker through the prophet and now through his own men, going back and giving the message to him. Therefore, he says, you shall not come down from the bed to which you have gone up, but you shall surely die. And then he said to them, what kind of a man was it who came up to meet you and told you these words? He's inquiring, who is this man? And they answered and said, a hairy man wearing a leather belt around his waist. And he said, it is Elijah the Tishbite that he knew right away. Can you imagine what it must have been like? I mean, Elijah is like John the Baptist. He's a wilderness man. Doesn't shave. Doesn't bathe. He's just running around. And I mean, he looks like a madman. And the king knows exactly who it is. And so he describes this guy as a hairy man. And then the king sent to him a captain of 50 with 50 of his men. And so he went up to him. So the king says, okay, give me 50 men. I want you guys to go and get Elijah and bring him here to me. And so the king sent to him 50 men with the captain. And so he went up to him and there was Elijah sitting down on top of a hill. He's just kind of kicking back. And his 50 people show up. And then he spoke to him, men of God, the king has said, come down. Notice, they're in charge. So Elijah answered and said to the captain of 50, hey, listen, I love Elijah. If I am a man of God, then let fire come down from heaven and consume you and your 50 men. And the fire came down and barbecued all of them. Can you imagine that? A miracle. I mean, this is in the Old Testament. Here is the prophet of God. Now, for such a time as this, God is using Elijah. 50 men and the captain are gone. He's just going to kick him back. And then he sent another 50. And his 50 men, he answered and said to him, men of God, thus saith the king says, come down quickly. I mean, the first 50 I would learn before I would send the second batch. Man, something's happening here. But notice the rebellion, the harshness of heart here and the hardness of heart. So Elijah answered and said to them, look it. If I am a man of God, let fire come down from heaven and consume you and your 50 men. And the fire of God cannot and barbecue them all. That's now 102 men. Imagine that. Gone. Totally burned. And again, the third one came, but this one was smarter. And the captain came of 50 with his 50 men. And the third captain of 50 went up and he came and he fell on his knees before Elijah. Smart. He humbles himself. And what does he say? He says, and he pleaded with him and said unto him, men of God, please let my life and the life of these 50 men, your servants, notice, be precious in your sight. Please don't barbecue us. Notice that. Be merciful to us. Look, fire has come down from heaven and burned up the first two captains and their 50s, but let my life not be precious in your sight. And check this out. Elijah was getting ready to call fire, right? But what happens? The angel of the Lord intervenes. Interesting. Who's our intercessor? Jesus Christ. The angel of the Lord said to Elijah, go down with him. Hey, notice how God is directing. But listen also carefully. Elisha was doing what? Listening. How can we be led if we don't listen to do anything for God? Elisha was just waiting on the Lord. And God was speaking to him and directing him as a prophet of the Lord. Watch this. Go down with him. Do not be afraid of him. And so he rose and went down with him to the king. And notice that first of all that he goes down. Why? Because God assures him it's okay. If God doesn't speak to me and I go down, I may never come back. You see? You got to know. You got to know that God has said it. And that God made the promise. Because if we don't have God's seal or God's approval or God's leading or God's guiding, it's going to be on our own. He's not with us. You want to make sure he's with you all the way through in whatever you do. So what does Elijah do? Then he said to him, thus saith the Lord, because you have sent messengers to inquire of Baal-zebub, the god of Ekron. He said, because there is no God in Israel to inquire at his word. This is the fourth time. Fourth time that he says to him, hey, what's the matter with you? Don't you know there is a God? Because your gods are phony. Therefore you shall not come down from the bed in which you have gone up, but you shall surely die. And listen, we could not say that unless God is with us. Just like bringing fire. Can you imagine? You say, fire come down, no fire comes down. You're going to look pretty silly. You got to know that God is with me. And God said it. Because there are too many people saying, the Lord told me when God hasn't spoken. We have to be careful. Did God really speak to you? Did God really lead you? Have you really heard the voice of the Lord through his word? Or as you're listening to the radio or TV or somebody communicating with you where God speaks to you, or you're reading a book and God speaks to you. That's how God speaks to us. So many ways. And so Ahaziah died according to the word of the Lord. Notice God's word is sure, which Elijah had spoken, because he had no son. Jehoram became king in his place in the second year of Jehoram, the son of Jehoshaphat, king of Judah. Now, don't get confused. There's going to be two Jehorahams, one in the northern kingdom and one in the southern kingdom. Two different people. And now the rest of the acts of Ahaziah, which he did, are they not written in the book of the Chronicles of the kings of Israel? Yes, we'll get there when we get to Chronicles. Now in chapter 2, this chapter now brings to us the end of the ministry of the prophet Elijah, and then Elisha comes into the scene. And it came to pass, when the Lord was about to take up Elijah into heaven by a whirlwind that Elijah went with Elisha from Gilgal. Now, what's really incredible here, notice, it was not fire that took Elijah to heaven. It was a whirlwind. So many times we hear preachers say that the fire took him. No. The whirlwind took him to heaven. What are we talking about? Well, we're going to see in a moment that there are only two people that never died. Two people in the Bible. Elijah and Enoch. Two people. Enoch is back in Genesis chapter 5, 21 through 24. He went out for a walk, never came back. God took him to heaven. Elijah is coming to the end of his ministry. And listen, every one of us will come to the end of our lives whenever God says it. God already has a plan. God already has the time, the day, the year that you're going to die and I'm going to die. Pre-rapture theology believes that there is a generation that will never die like Elijah and Enoch. And we call that what? The rapture of the church. Where God is going to take his bride home, just like Elijah and Enoch. So here we have the two prophets. He says, and then Elijah said to Elisha, stay here, please, for the Lord has sent me on to Bethel, which is the house of God. But Elisha said, as the Lord lives and as your soul lives, I will not leave you. So they went down together. He said, I'm not going to leave you because I know you're going to die. God's going to take you. God told Elisha and God told some of the prophets that Elijah was going to go to be with the Lord. Imagine that. They knew. So they didn't want to separate from, I'm going to stay right with you, man. The reason that Elijah wanted to stay with Elijah is because Elijah wanted a double portion of the anointing of the Holy Spirit that Elijah had in his life. Not a bad asking. Give me, Lord, a double portion of the Spirit of God.
As you contemplate the powerful Spirit-led lives of Elijah and Elisha, we hope you'll follow their example of listening for the Lord's direction and committing to obedience. You're listening to Somebody Loves You Radio with Raul Reese. Today's program is available in its complete form for a donation of $5 or more. If you'd like to get a copy for yourself or for a loved one, just call us at 800-634-9165 and ask for Raul's teaching from 2 Kings chapters 1 and 2. We'd also like to tell you about Raul's booklet titled Sin, The Root of All Evil. Exploring the dangers of spiritual compromise, you'll be challenged to evaluate the areas where you might be tempted to stray from the Lord and guard against them with the help of the Holy Spirit. Learning how your small daily decisions can honor God, you'll find new ways to live for eternity in the Lord's perfect will. To order Rawls' booklet titled Sin, The Root of All Evil, visit SomebodyLovesYou.com or call 800-634-9165. We'll send your copy for just $8 plus shipping and handling. The number once again is 800-634-9165. To order by writing us, our mailing address is Somebody Loves You Radio, Post Office Box 4440, Diamond Bar, California, 91765. Watch Raul on his YouTube channel every Tuesday at 10 a.m. West Coast time for Straight Talk, a Q&A program with helpful guidance for a God-honoring life. And every one of these programs has also been archived for you to download through Spotify or iTunes. Plus, you can contact Raul directly with prayer requests and Bible questions by emailing him at pastorraul@somebodylovesyou.com. Your partnership enables us to keep sharing the truth of God's Word, and every contribution is tax deductible. Be sure and join us next time for our continuing study of 2 Kings. You'll see that like the mighty prophets Elijah and Elisha, you can serve the Lord with boldness and authority when you fully commit to obeying His perfect will. Here's Raul once again with the closing comment.
I really believe this is part of the problem in the church today. The anointing of the Holy Spirit over His servants. Asking God to baptize us. asking God to fill us. As we have models in the church, in the congregation, within the pulpits of America, men that are godly men, men that are anointed of God, because of the anointing that the Holy Spirit has put over their lives, like Elijah and Elijah. Here Elijah recognized his servant, his master's anointing, Elijah, that truly he was a man of God and that God was working miracles and wonders through him. And he became a follower and a disciple of Elijah.
This program is sponsored by Somebody Loves You Radio in Diamond Bar, California.